Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. Today we'll be working on fusion graphic design. We'll create this classic design using an image. We'll use layer mask and layer style option to create out this effect. We'll also use cardboard texture as an overlay to give a vintage effect. So let's begin the tutorial. Open a new Photoshop document, give the width 2000 pixel and the height 1100 pixel, then click OK. Now drag in this image from the folder, convert it into smart object. This way we can edit the image anytime. Now drag this image into our main document. Scale on the size and create a duplicate. Now scale up the size with the anchor point set at the center of the headphone. Now draw a circle using the circular selection tool. Then with the command or control shift and I, you can invert the selection area. Then click on the mask option to mask out the region. Adjust the size of the image using the transform option. You can also adjust the mask area. Click on the mask thumbnail with the control pressed. This will make a selection. Then set the anchor point to the center and adjust the size. Next, we'll create one more duplicate of the top image layer. Increase the size and adjust the mask area. In this way, we'll create three more image layers using the same steps. Make sure that the spacing between all the images are equidistant from each other. Now, with the command or control pressed, click on the mask thumbnail of the largest image layer. This will make a circular selection. Invert the selection area using the shortcut command or control shift and I. Add a new layer and fill it up with white color. Next, we'll add drop shadow. So double click on the first image layer. This will open a layer style panel. Take drop shadow and set the spread to 8 pixel and the size to 9 pixel. For the second image layer, make a selection of mask area and increase the selection area. Adjust the mask region for third and fourth layers. Now, add drop shadow in the second layer. Set the spread to 26 pixel and the size to 10 pixel. To apply the same effect to the third layer, drag and drop the drop shadow effect to the third layer with the alt pressed. Then set the spread value to 13 pixel and the size to 13 pixel. Use the eraser tool to clean up the mask region. Select the mask area and erase out the unwanted lines and curves. Then apply drop shadow for the fourth layer. Set the spread value to 18 and the size to 16 pixel. Next, we'll add a texture to the overall design. So drag in this cardboard texture, create multiple duplicates with the alt press to fill up the whole artboard. Now select all the texture layer and convert it into smart object. Change the layer mode to overlay. Next, select the white layer and apply color overlay under layer style panel. Choose gray color and click OK. This will give a light brown tone to the design. Now, we'll do some adjustments, so add a hue and saturation adjustment layer. Set the hue value around -7 and the saturation to -23. Then add brightness and contrast adjustment layer. Set the brightness to -11 and the contrast to 8. Then add a curve adjustment layer. Adjust the red, green and blue curves. Change the overlay color to little brighter to make the background lighter. Next, type out a text fusion and apply impact regular font. Give alphabet spacing around -20, then add two more text, graphic and design. Apply simplified Arabic bold for graphic and Kalinga regular font for design. For fusion, choose dark blue color and add inner shadow to give depth to design. Lastly, scale up the size and do the proper placement. If the circular border edges are not sharp, we can use eraser tool to get a sharp cut. Adjust the size of the eraser as per your need and just click. You'll get a clean design. Next, we'll add white highlight rings to each layer. To do that, create a duplicate of the layer, hide drop shadow, add stroke under layer style panel, set the position to inside and change the color to white. In the same way, select the under image layer and create a duplicate. Hide the drop shadow effect and apply white stroke under layer style panel. Follow the same steps for all the other image layers. Also make sure to convert all the highlighted layers to smart object. After this, select the individual layers and apply layer mask. Now with a black soft brush, mask out the area where you don't want to show the highlights. Do this for all the layers. Then using the smaller brush tool, hide out the patches to give us smooth highlight rings. Finally, we have completed design in Fusion Graphic Design. We have given a vintage look using the cardboard texture. We have also used layer mask option in a very unique way to get the final output. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, like, share and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.